And the question, the spirituality,
yeah.
worship, sir, how important is the spirituality or worship, and what is worship and what is the spirituality?
Excellent, because today is the most appropriate day for discussing sir. All these things, I believe, because spirituality is something which is our own.
Sir.
Actually, spirituality is our realistic dimension. All these days, instead of getting identified with our own selves, our own truest dimension, we have been using some other thing as ourselves. So much of pain has come, so much of separation has come, so much of sorrow, suffering, everything we see in the world could only be attributed to only one thing, that we are separated from our real source. The day we connect ourselves with our truest source, there will not be even an iota of pain or any other thing. So that way, spirituality is the recognition of our own self. In the Shiva Sutras, there are a set of sutras called Shiva Sutras. There it says, Chaitanyam Atma. Atma is real Chaitanya. Our own self is nothing but consciousness. All these days we were thinking that I am just the matter. I am this frame, and only those who belong to this frame are mine. See how we have narrowed down,
yes,
how
sir.
We have confused, and how we have cluttered everything. That's a very sorry state of affairs which we are into. That's why so much of confusion, calamity and catastrophe is there outside. Because wrong identification certainly leads to wrong things only. Shivaratri, especially Mahashivaratri, is a momentous occasion for us to realize what we are, how to connect us with our own self, how to realize, how to become free from all these things, how to liberate ourselves from ignorance, how to get rid of all the delusion, how to move beyond all the illusions, and how to stand in face with the reality, the supreme truth, Satyam Advaitam.
And going to the next question,
yeah.
The highlight of the importance of, can you please highlight the importance of Sri Rudram, sir?
Excellent, because actually today, in countless temples today, you will be hearing the divine chanting of Sri Rudram. So before entering into the topic of Sri Rudram, I will give you the understanding regarding the particular word Rudra. Rudra is none other than Shiva. Shiva and Rudra both are one. Shiva, when he removes our dukkha, he is called Rudra. Rudra. Ru means all our suffering.
It could be a savior.
Yes, because he pulls us out of all the troubles which we are into presently. These troubles, one who removes all these troubles is Rudra. That is why Sri Rudra, Sri
okay.
Rudra, Sri Rudra is the most efficacious hymn available to us in the entire Veda.
Sir.
I tell you one thing.
Sir.
We have originally three Vedas, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda and Sama Veda. Of the three Vedas, the middle one is the Yajur Veda.
Sir.
As you all know, each Veda is divided into Samhita, Brahmana, Aranyaka and the Upanishad, four parts. Samhita is the mantra bhaga, Brahmana is the yajnika bhaga, and Upasana bhaga forms this Aranyaka. Then the reality as the supreme truth, Advaita, is found in the Upanishads. So every Veda has got Samhita, Brahmana, Aranyaka and the Upanishads. So here, what happens is, Rig Veda is there, Sama Veda is there, in between you have Yajur Veda. And in that Yajur Veda also, there are, in the Taittiriya Samhita, we have seven sections or khandas, they call it. Of the seven khandas, the middle one is fourth one. That fourth part contains the magnificent hymn called Sri Rudram, which at once puts an end to all the delusion. It really liberates us instantly. That is why we offer water, we do Rudra Mantra Abhishekam to the Lord every day, and especially on Shiva Ratri, we do it throughout the night, because Shiva Ratri has got three primal aspects. First is Upavasa.
Upavasa.
Yes. And the second one is Lingodbhava. And finally, the third one is Jagarana. The three elements are there in Mahashivaratri. Here, Upavasa means staying close to the God, which means remaining in the state of godly consciousness. Remaining in a divine state of consciousness is called Upavasa. So, that is the realistic meaning of the term Upavasa. So, what happens when you are in the thought of God, contemplation of God, meditation of God? Naturally, reality dawns within you, and that is called Lingodbhava. That dawn of the reality, dawn of the light, dawn of the knowledge and dawn of the wisdom is called Lingodbhava. So, it is not happening outside, it is happening within us. Actually, Mahashivaratri is to be understood in a transfigurative way, that Mahashivaratri is actually happening within us, because there is so much going on within us. Here, due to the constant contemplation of the Panchakshari Mahamantra, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, continuously by the devotee, and staying in that awareness of the supreme state of the Shiva, what happens is there will be dawn of the light, and that light is Lingodbhava. And finally, when that consciousness of Shiva comes, at once you will be freed from all these earthly things, and you will be one with your own self. Then, what is called Jagarana is nothing but Jagarana means keeping awake. Awake means not simply not losing sleep, but to be in the awareness of the self, to be in the awareness of the God, to be in the awareness of the divinity, to be in the awareness of the godliness, to be in the awareness of the Brahman, to be in the awareness of the Supreme Truth, to be in the awareness of Advaita forever. That is real Jagarana. That is how Shivaratri needs to be conducted. Actually, in a sense, Shivaratri is the supreme celebration of Advaita. It is the celebration of Advaita. So, that is the essence of Shivaratri.
That's really wonderful, sir.
Oh.
And we had a wonderful satsang in the name of Shiva.
Oh, very nice. I am also equally happy.
I hope we'll be having infinite blessings.
Definitely. And I pray God that not only you, sir, all the countless viewers of CVR channel,
yes,
will be blessed by the Lord in all His glory. Thank
sir.
You so much.
We are very fortunate to have you, sir. And we'll conclude the show with the Mahamantra Om.
Om.
Sir.
Om. Very nice. Thank you.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om.